Hello, my name is Ksenia and we are learning Russian. Some of my students asked me to give words meaning relatives, family members, so let's do it. And you may know that at my channel I pay a lot of attention to Russian grammar, so let's learn feminine and masculine genders using these words. You may see whether a noun is a masculine or feminine gender from its ending, but not always. Say masculine gender nouns end with a consonant sound and sound y, but not always. There are exceptions and other endings, and feminine gender nouns end with a, ya, and there are exceptions as well. So now we learn words meaning family members and define their gender. Let's start. We start with mother, mommy, mama. Mama is more mommy rather than mother. Mother, мать more official, мама more colloquial, we use it in our everyday speech. Mother, mommy, мама, feminine gender, ending a. Daddy, папа, here you may see an exception, it's masculine gender because it's daddy, man, but it ends with a, папа, masculine gender. Grandmother, бабушка, feminine gender, and grandfather, дедушка, as well exception, masculine gender, ends with a. Мама, папа, бабушка, дедушка, and there are also aunt and uncle, aunt, тетя. Feminine gender, uncle, дядя, masculine gender, дядя, and sister and brother, sister, сестра, feminine gender, and brother, брат, now good, masculine gender ends with consonant sound, brother, брат, сестра, брат, дядя, тетя, сестра, брат. And son and daughter, son, сын, and daughter, дочь. Here is a kind of exception as well, because it's дочь is a feminine gender, daughter, she's a girl or a lady, but it ends with a consonant sound with soft sign in the end, дочь, сын, дочь. Niece and nephew, niece, племянница, feminine, R, племянница, nephew, племянник, masculine, ends with consonant, племянница, племянник, niece, nephew, and mother-in-law, but we have different words for a mother-in-law, for a man, for a man and for a woman. I mean mother of your husband is свекровь. Mother of your husband is свекровь, mother-in-law. And a mother of your wife, if you are a man, and a man if you have a wife, and your mother is тёща, mother-in-law, but тёща, свекровь. Complicated. And wife of your son, daughter-in-law, wife of your son, сноха, and son-in-law, husband of your daughter, зять, and here свекровь also, mother-in-law, feminine gender but ends with consonant sound, тёща, feminine gender ends with a, тёща, and сноха, daughter-in-law ends with a, сноха, and зять, son-in-law ends with consonant sound, masculine gender. Why do you have to know a gender of a noun when you make a sentence? Because adjectives and pronouns will change their endings depending on a gender of a noun. Say, my father, my mother, my мой. My father, my daddy, мой папа. But my mommy, моя мама. Мой masculine, моя feminine. Мой папа, моя мама. And you have to know a gender of a noun to use a pronoun in the correct form. Now let's use pronoun my with all these words that we've learned today. Моя мама, мой папа, моя бабушка, мой дедушка, мой дядя, uncle, моя тетя, aunt, моя сестра, сестра easy, sister, similar, мой брат, also easy, мой сын, моя дочь, you may guess yourself, дочь, daughter, мой племянник, племянник, nephew, моя племянница, niece, моя свекровь, mother-in-law, моя теща, also mother-in-law, моя сноха, daughter-in-law, мой зять, son-in-law. And now let's take these words with adjectives, changing endings depending on a gender. The idea is the same as with a pronoun, but I want to give you several examples for you to remember it better, to be more sure that you remember endings and genders. So let's take a noun, adjective kind, добрый, and use it with all these words. Добрый, feminine, masculine, добрая, feminine, добрая мама, добрый папа, добрая бабушка, добрый дедушка, добрый дядя, добрая тетя, добрая сестра, добрый брат, добрый сын, добрая дочь, добрая племянница, добрый племянник, добрая свекровь, добрая теща, добрая сноха, добрый зять. And now an adjective beloved, beloved, любимый. Say, if I say любимая брат, is it correct? You may remember. No, любимый брат, masculine gender, and любимая сестра, sister, brother. So let's use любимый with all these words. Любимая мама, любимый папа, любимая бабушка, любимый дедушка, grandfather, любимый дядя, uncle, любимая тетя, любимая сестра, любимый брат, любимый сын, любимая дочь, любимый племянник, любимая племянница, любимая свекровь, mother-in-law, любимая теща, mother-in-law. Do you love your mother-in-law? Любимая сноха, любимый зять. And one more word, strict, strict, строгий, строгий, строгая мама, строгий папа, строгая бабушка, строгий дедушка, строгий дядя, строгая тетя, строгая сестра, строгий брат, строгий сын, сын, строгая дочь, строгий племянник, nephew, строгая племянница, строгая свекровь, mother-in-law, строгая теща, mother-in-law, строгая сноха, daughter-in-law, строгий зять, son-in-law. And Russian grammar even more complicated. If you use nouns in different cases, you will have to change endings of a noun and a pronoun or an adjective. Say, my sister, моя сестра. But if you say, I meet my sister at the airport, я встречаю мою сестру в аэропорту. Моя сестра, я встречаю мою сестру в аэропорту. But I don't want to frighten you right now. It's okay if you don't know all these endings. You just say as you may and people will understand you. But if you want to learn all these endings in all these cases, you may subscribe to my everyday WhatsApp lessons. Link is in the description of this video. Then we learn all endings, all examples, all cases every day, little bit by little bit. So anyway, now let's take the words that we've learned today in a sentence. Say, my mother is going to see me today. For all words, my mother is going to see me today. Моя мама приезжает ко мне сегодня. Моя мама приезжает ко мне сегодня. And we and only the first two words will be changed. All the other part of a sentence will stay the same. It's just for you to remember words and genders. My mother is going to see me today. Моя мама приезжает ко мне сегодня. My father is going to see me today. Мой папа приезжает ко мне сегодня. Бабушка, гранни. Моя бабушка приезжает ко мне сегодня. Grandfather. Мой дедушка приезжает ко мне сегодня. Uncle. Мой дядя приезжает ко мне сегодня. Aunt. Моя тетя приезжает ко мне сегодня. Sister. Моя сестра приезжает ко мне сегодня. Brother. Мой брат приезжает ко мне сегодня. And now let's take another sentence because too much of guests. Say, who is next? Брат, сестра, son. My son is going to a sea. To a sea. He has a vacation. Мой сын едет на море. Daughter. Моя дочь едет на море. Море, sea. Nephew, мой племянник едет на море. Niece, моя племянница едет на море. Mother-in-law, моя свекровь едет на море. Another mother-in-law. Моя теща едет на море. Daughter-in-law, моя сноха едет на море. Son-in-law, мой зять едет на море. And now let's have a little training, as we usually do in all my lessons. I say English sentence and you say Russian sentence. It's important for you to mind моя, and to remember a word meaning a relative, certain relative. So let's take that your relative is going to visit you today. My mother, my mommy is going to visit me today, to see me today. You say Russian. Моя мама приезжает ко мне сегодня. Сегодня, today. My daddy is going to visit me today. Мой папа приезжает ко мне сегодня. My grandmother is going to visit me today. Моя бабушка приезжает ко мне сегодня. My grandfather is going to visit me today, to see me today. Мой дедушка приезжает ко мне сегодня. My uncle is going to visit me today. Мой дядя приезжает ко мне сегодня. My aunt is going to visit me today. Моя тетя приезжает ко мне сегодня. My sister is going to see me today. Моя сестра приезжает ко мне сегодня. My brother is going to see me today. Мой брат приезжает ко мне сегодня. And now let's also take to go to a sea. My son is going to a sea. Мой сын едет на море. My daughter is going to a sea. Моя дочь едет на море. My nephew is going to a sea. Мой племянник едет на море. And my niece is going to a sea. Моя племянница едет на море. Mother-in-law, mother of your husband is going to a sea. Моя свекровь едет на море. And mother-in-law, mother of your wife is going to a sea. Моя теща едет на море. My daughter-in-law is going to a sea. Моя сноха едет на море. And my son-in-law is going to a sea. Мой зять едет на море. And now one more exercise. I say a Russian word. Мама, папа. And you add a adjective kind, добрый. And you have to use right ending. Say, мама, добрая мама. Папа, добрый папа. Okay? So, let's start. Мама, you say, добрая мама. Папа, добрый папа. Бабушка, добрая бабушка. Дедушка, добрый дедушка. Дядя, добрый дядя. Тетя, добрая тетя. Сестра, добрая сестра. Брат, добрый брат. Сын, добрый сын. Дочь, добрая дочь. Племянник, добрый племянник. Племянница, добрая племянница. Свекровь, добрая свекровь. Теща, добрая теща. Сноха, добрая сноха. Зять, добрый зять. Молодец! So it's enough for today. We've learned a lot. If you see my video for the first time, then please follow my YouTube channel. Also join our Facebook page. If you want to learn cases of nouns, adjectives using with nouns, then please subscribe my everyday WhatsApp lessons. So, see you in my next lesson. Let's learn Russian and make friends. Давайте учить русский и дружить. Пока!